He sent his spirit. Psalm 104. Psalm 104 verse 30. He sent his word. I'm talking about the word. Okay, let me quote Psalm 104 verse 30. Say, when you send your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the ground. When you send your spirit, they are created. So where your spirit is, this creation. Now if banga ripanduka, this restoration. Apata pari ifupa will be created. So when you send your spirit, oh God, send your spirit. I know you send the word, but when I say send your spirit, I want let people see your spirit, not empty words, not empty Christianity, but your word, but your spirit. Where your spirit is, is creation. Where your spirit is liberty. Where your spirit is, where your spirit is, people are delivered from destruction. Where you sent your word and healed them. One, you healed them. Two, you delivered them. So it's your word which heals. It is your word which delivers. Without your word, no healing. Without your word, no deliverance. Because your word is spirit. Because your words are spirit. That's why when you send your spirit, they are created. When you send your word, they are created. Lord, send your word before I speak. Send your spirit to your people before I talk to them. Send your spirit, Lord, before I talk to them. Because when you send your spirit, creation will happen. Send your word so that they may be healing. Send your word so that they may be deliverance. The living stone. The absence of healing, the absence of deliverance, is evident. It's total evidence. It's total evidence. It's total evidence. That there is no spirit of God. I refuse to be without the spirit of God. I refuse to possess the Bible without your spirit, without the Holy Ghost. It's better not to share if you are not in it. It's better. It's better.
I am not going to be confounded. Lekura Baba Yaski. I am on Mount Zion, where there is innumerable kindness. Where there is everlasting pain. Hey, Papa Raski, Papa Raski.